This video is a response to a question in the Genshin Impact fan group, which is not only interesting, but also useful for many of us players. The posters ask people to vote on what is best for his character CL. Choice A, 53.4 critical rate with 207 critical damage, or choice B, 81.4 critical rate with 157.2 critical damage. To be able to answer this question, we need to understand the critical damage mechanism. The following formula is taken from one page in the GenshinImpactFandom.com, the link to which is given in the description below. According to the formula, if the damage is a critical hit, outgoing damage critical is equal to outgoing damage non-critical multiplied by, in parentheses, 1 plus percent critical damage. Moreover, if you want to deliver the highest accumulated damage in all the times your character hits, you need to calculate the average outgoing damage, or AOD, from the expected value of the binomial distribution of the critical hit, that is, average outgoing damage is equal to the probability of critical hit multiplied by outgoing damage critical plus the probability of non-critical hit multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical, where the probability of critical hit is equal to percent critical rate. Thus, average outgoing damage is equal to percent critical rate multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical multiplied by parentheses 1 plus percent critical damage in parentheses plus parentheses 1 minus percent critical rate in parentheses multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical. Factoring out the non-critical outgoing damage, we get average outgoing damage is equal to bracket percent critical rate multiplied by parentheses 1 plus percent critical damage in parentheses plus parentheses 1 minus percent critical rate in parentheses in a bracket multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical. Hence, our maximization problem becomes to maximize average outgoing damage by choosing percent critical rate and percent critical damage, subject to a function g which takes as its argument percent critical rate and percent critical damage. G must be less than or equal to k bar. This non-strict inequality is a constraint restricting our choices between increasing percent critical rate and increasing percent critical damage. To assist in our understanding of the optimization method, we assume that the function g has all well-defined partial derivatives at our optimal values of percent critical rate and percent critical damage. Here we employ the Lagrangian mechanics, starting by setting the Lagrangian function of the average outgoing damage to be maximized as L percent critical rate percent critical damage lambda is equal to bracket percent critical rate multiplied by parenthesis 1 plus percent critical damage plus 1 minus percent critical rate in a bracket multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical plus lambda multiplied by bracket k bar minus g. Assuming an interior solution, that is, an optimal solution with non-zero values of percent critical rate, percent critical damage, and lambda, we try to find the stationary point of the Lagrangian function by setting equal to zero its partial derivatives with respect to the percent critical rate, percent critical damage, and the Lagrangian multiplier lambda. Assuming that outgoing damage non-critical is not affected by our choice of percent critical rate or percent critical damage, the partial derivative of L with respect to percent critical rate, or dL by d percent critical rate, is equal to percent critical damage multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical minus lambda multiplied by dg by d percent critical rate. and R equal to 0. We call this equation 1. The partial derivative of L with respect to percent critical damage, or dL by d percent critical damage, is equal to percent critical rate multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical minus lambda multiplied by dg by d percent critical damage, or equal to 0. We call this equation 2. It's noteworthy that as outgoing damage non-critical is not affected by our choosing of percent critical rate and percent critical damage, the outgoing damage non-critical remains a constant in the face of differentiations by percent critical rate and percent critical damage. And finally, derivative of L with respect to lambda, or dL by d lambda, is equal to k bar minus g, and R equal to 0, which is the constraint itself. If dg by d percent critical damage is non-zero, rearranging the lambda in equation 1 and equation 2 gives lambda equal to percent critical damage multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical divided by dg by d percent critical rate equal to percent critical rate multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical divided by dg by d percent critical damage, or percent critical damage divided by percent critical rate is equal to dg by d percent critical rate divided by dg by d percent critical damage.
Order guide you.
The differentiability of g and the non-zero values of dg by d percent critical damage also allow us to invoke the implicit function theorem. Hence, dg by d percent critical rate divided by dg by d percent critical damage is equal to minus d percent critical damage by d percent critical rate. Thus, at our optimal values of percent critical rate and percent critical damage, we will have percent critical damage divided by percent critical rate equal to minus d percent critical damage by d percent critical rate. In any case that we can calculate the differences in percent critical rate and percent critical damage between choices, and the optimal solution is not too far from one of the choices, we can linearly approximate the right-hand side of the equation as percent critical damage divided by percent critical rate equal to minus d percent critical damage by d percent critical rate, approximately equal to minus delta percent critical damage divided by delta percent critical rate, which, my friends, is a true golden ratio for any critical damage critical rate questions. Given that the outgoing damage non-critical is not affected by choices of percent critical rate and percent critical damage, it says that if the ratio between your chosen percent critical damage and your chosen percent critical rate is approximately equal to the ratio of the difference in the percent critical damage to the difference in the percent critical rate between any pair of choices, your chosen percent critical damage and chosen percent critical rate will deliver the highest average outgoing damage, and hence the highest accumulated damage throughout all the attacking times.
Order guide you.
Back to the posted question, we have percent critical rate choice A is equal to 53.4, with percent critical damage choice A equal to 207, while percent critical rate choice B equal to 81.4, with percent critical damage choice B equal to 157.2. Thus, percent critical damage divided by percent critical rate can be approximated as minus delta percent critical damage divided by delta percent critical rate equal to minus percent critical damage choice B minus percent critical damage choice A, all divided by percent critical rate choice B minus percent critical rate choice A, equal to minus 157.2 minus 207, all divided by 81.4 minus 53.4, equal to 1.7786. Comparing between choice A and choice B, we get percent critical damage choice A divided by percent critical rate choice A equal to 3.8764, while percent critical damage choice B divided by percent critical rate choice B equal to 1.9312. So we can see here that both ratios are not the ideal optimized solution to get the highest average outgoing damage. Then, which one is the closest to the optimized ratio? Yes, choice B, as its ratio is much closer to 1.7786. So the answer to this question is choice B, namely 81.4 critical rate with 157.2 critical damage. This can also be shown by calculating the average outgoing damage of each choice. AOD choice A equal to bracket percent critical rate choice A multiplied by parenthesis 1 plus percent critical damage choice A in parenthesis plus parenthesis 1 minus percent critical rate choice A in parenthesis in bracket multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical, which is equal to bracket 0.534 multiplied by parenthesis 1 plus 2.07 in parenthesis plus parenthesis 1 minus 0.534 in parenthesis in bracket multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical, which is equal to 2.10538 multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical, while AOD choice B equal to bracket percent critical rate choice B multiplied by parenthesis 1 plus percent critical damage choice B plus parenthesis 1 minus percent critical rate choice B in parenthesis in bracket multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical equal to bracket 0.814 multiplied by parenthesis 1 plus 1.572 in parenthesis plus parenthesis 1 minus 0.814 in parenthesis in bracket multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical, which is equal to 2.279608 multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical. As we can see, choice B has a higher AOD in line with our comparison earlier. In addition, the player can increase the average outgoing damage even more by reducing the percent critical damage and increasing the percent critical rate each by a small amount. We have shown that the optimal pair of percent critical rate and percent critical damage must observe delta percent critical damage divided by delta percent critical rate equal to minus 1.7786. Thus, we have percent critical damage optimal minus percent critical damage choice B all divided by percent critical rate optimal minus percent critical rate choice B must be equal to minus 1.7786 or so. Substituting the knowns values into this gives percent critical damage optimal minus 1.572 all divided by percent critical rate optimal minus 0.814 equal to minus 1.7786, which we call equation 3, and also percent critical damage optimal divided by percent critical rate optimal must be approximately equal to 1.7786, or percent critical damage optimal is approximately equal to 1.7786 times percent critical rate optimal, which we call equation 4. Substituting 4 into 3 and rearranging the terms, we get 1.7786 multiplied by percent critical rate optimal minus 1.572 is equal to minus 1.7786 multiplied by parenthesis percent critical rate optimal minus 0.814. Then percent critical rate optimal is equal to parenthesis minus 1.7786 multiplied by minus 0.814 in parenthesis plus 1.572 all divided by parenthesis 1.7786 plus 1.7786, which is equal to 0.8489. And percent critical damage optimal is equal to 1.7786 multiplied by percent critical rate optimal, which is equal to 1.5099. Calculating the optimal average outgoing damage, we get AOD optimal equal to bracket percent critical rate optimal multiplied by parenthesis 1 plus percent critical damage optimal in parenthesis plus parenthesis 1 minus percent critical rate optimal in parenthesis in bracket multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical, which is equal to bracket 0.8489 multiplied by parenthesis 1 plus 1.5099 in parenthesis plus parenthesis 1 minus 0.8489 in parenthesis in bracket multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical, which is equal to 2.2817541 multiplied by outgoing damage non-critical, which is unsurprisingly higher than the average outgoing damage of choice B and higher than any other choice that observes the choice restricting constraint. Therefore, we can see now that the golden ratio that we derive from the method of Lagrangian mechanics can give us the highest average outgoing damage by our characters. If you find this video useful or informative, we would appreciate your pressing like, sharing it, or subscribing to the channel. Thank you.